Hey there, Mr. Lonely Heart, if you could find the time, I would like to sit and talk to see if we could find the answer to the mystery of love's most precious seed. Is it in a touch or in a kiss or simply in the knee? Or is it really love itself that always wants to give the heart and soul of all of us and everything that lives? Hey there, Mr. Cold, Cold Heart, I know I could be wrong to think that life could be so sweet and love could be so strong as together every one of us, like one big family, to share with one another all we have and all we see. It's true, the deepest part of us is everywhere the same, and that the only differences are really just the names. We can join the children's song and show them that we care. Let them know we're on their side, no matter when or where. We can free their hearts from fear and hunger, reconcile. We can give a child a chance and give a child a smile. True love is still the answer, and we are still the way. The gift is in the giving and in living what we say. And if you have a lonely heart, this song is just for you, to ask for all that you can give and all that you can do. Remember that the mystery of love's most precious seed is in the heart of all of us. True love is all we need. It's in the heart of all of us. True love is all we need. Within the heart of all of us, true love is all we need. Within the heart of all.
Won't you give today the united way, bring happiness. happiness again.
You know, I've sung about this country and its people. My music has made me a neighbor to people all around the globe. I've come to see the warmth and love of people in all lands. And I've tried to capture the heart of this nation in the songs that I sing. To tell about that love that's in all of us. I've written about the joy and, unfortunately, some of the sorrow in our lives. Because in my travels, I've seen people who are hungry and helpless. I've seen the striving for peace and freedom and equality that's in all people. And I've learned that here in America, we have a very special love of liberty and a heritage of caring which was born right here at the foot of the Rocky Mountains in Denver in 1887. It grew from our pioneer roots, and it's a spirit of neighbor helping neighbor. I want to show you how that spirit is working every day in the lives of people just like you. Let me take you on a magical journey to show you that today, out there across this land, there are people working to help the sick, the aged, the poor, and the handicapped. We've come to call it the United Way. In towns and cities and from the green rolling hills of the east, across the great plains and painted deserts, to the high Rockies and the western shore, there are people who make that spirit come alive every day in a thousand ways. Come with me and seek out and understand the spirit in our land that's in all of us. This is Irv Klein. For years, they called him, well, eccentric. An old man on an old blue bike riding through the city, clearing trash off vacant lots, and then planting flowers where wine bottles and beer cans and debris had been. Now, where the flowers grew, no one threw trash. And so his own neighborhood is where he's made his niche, spending his spare time and vacations helping. So what does this say now? Southern Park Senior Citizens Garden. A group of organizations and a United Way volunteer named Irv Klein rallied the community to help in the development of this park.
This is where I learned about the United Way and how they help people and what it means to be a volunteer.
He's 70 years old now, but since he's retired, he's taken on his biggest challenge, this park, and he's made it work. 5 years ago, it was covered with dilapidated old buildings, abandoned and condemned. With the help of United Way Venture Grants, Irv Klein and his neighbors have transformed 6 acres on one side into the largest vegetable garden in the city. Now low-income families have vegetables that they've grown, and children pick strawberries that they planted. And working together with United Way, they're expanding this park and their own horizons. Because Irv Klein on his old blue bike is the kind of guy who makes things happen. There's much more to tell you about the United Way and how it's working in your town. How people in each community created the United Way because there were so many good agencies and programs to support. But telling you the stories isn't good enough. You have to see and hear them for yourself. I want you to meet Paul and Shirley. A happily married couple, they already had one healthy, beautiful child. And Shirley was pregnant with twins. The future looked bright, and then tragedy struck.
One minute, I was just a normal mom, delivering normal baby, and Matthew was born, and a hush fell over the delivery room. We were told that Matthew would never walk, that he would probably be mildly to moderately retarded at best. And with Michael, they said he'd probably be totally paralyzed on the left side, blind and deaf, and possibly severely retarded.
About this time, the bills started to mount. We were emotional trauma, and we just needed help. We didn't know where to turn.
We couldn't qualify for assistance through any of the normal assistance programs assisting at the time, and somehow somebody at United Way called me on the phone and they said, what are your problems? And so we started listing them and they said, well, we can take care of this and we can take care of that. And knowing that there were people that were willing to give us some immediate support so that we could find our way was really great.
They seemed very concerned with the family. What can we do to help you out to survive, to continue as a family? And they structured something that worked for us and worked for the children.
Matt has more courage than anybody I know and more perseverance than anyone I know. And when I first saw Michael, Dan, I just cried. I thought it was something I might never see. It was just overwhelming to see that he could do that and to believe that, yes, he will walk.
These two little guys have had to face more in a year and a half than we have to face in a lifetime. And they still come out smiling. The United Way cares about families. And most families want to make it on their own. They don't want a handout. They just want a chance. And that's why I want to tell you the story of Jerry Armstrong. When Jerry was born, she seemed a normal, healthy child. But when she was 2 and a half, the doctors discovered a rare form of cancer in her eyes. Her only hope lay in surgery that would save her life, but leave her blind. Can you imagine her parents and the inevitable decision they had to make to save their daughter's life, but to lose her sight? They chose life, and the United Way was there. Through the help of United Way volunteers, Jerry was sent to a special school, a school where a United Way agency supplies Braille books and maps, opening a whole new world for children like Jerry.
Up, 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 faster and faster, and faster and faster the little engine climbed, until at last they reached the top of the mountain.
Huh? Well, that was 8 years ago. Now I want you to meet Jerry today, at 16. Because people cared and gave, Jerry has a full life before her, with all the hopes and dreams we would want for our own children. When you see a little blind girl growing into a bright, intelligent young lady, you really have to feel good about yourself and the town you live in, where people care enough to make things better through the United Way. Perhaps through a child who cannot see, we can all see that love is all we need. That's why this song is for you.
When you lend a helping hand, you give yourself away, becoming part of something more than words could ever say. A brother to your neighbor, to those in need, a friend. Please give today the United Way, bring happiness again. True love is still the answer, we are still the way. The gift is in the giving, and in living what we say. If you have a lonely heart, this song is just for you. To ask for all that you can give and all that you can do. Remember that the mystery of love's most precious seed is in the heart of all of us. True love is all we need. It's in the heart of all.
This is John Denver asking you to make your United Way pledge now. Because thanks to you, it works for all of us, the United Way.